Okay, so some of you might know I have a previous video out on this where I was showing you how to switch between presets, right? Because at the time, all I was able to do was to use MIDI to trigger some keyboard shortcuts that would tell GarageBand to switch preset. So I would just save my pedals and amps as a preset and switch through those. But then I've looked into it more, and now I think I found a way to actually access single individual elements on the interface, the user interface of GarageBand, so that you could use MIDI to trigger, I don't know, turning on and off a pedal, moving a switch or something. So that's what I'm gonna show you today. Okay, so what do you need? You're gonna need a little utility, which is absolutely free, and it doesn't even need to be installed. Like, it's not copying files into hidden folders and messing with your hard drive in any way. You just download it, double click on it, and you're good to go. And it's called MIDIPipe. So let's open, in my case, Chrome. You can open whatever browser you use. And you're gonna go to this site right here. I'm gonna put the link in the description. It's subtlesoft.squaresoft.net/midipipe.html. And depending on your OS, you might wanna download different versions, but I am on, what am I on? I'm on Ventura 13 point whatever, and it works perfectly. So even though it says here up until Mac OS 12, it will work in Ventura as well. Or if you have an older Mac, you might want to download this version right here. But anyways, you just download it and that's it. As I said, you don't need to install it. You can just open it right away, and this is what it looks like. So basically on the left side, you have different MIDI modules that do different things. Like, you have a message converter if you want to change CCs to notes, for instance. You have a transpose module here. You have various things. And then on the right side, you have your own custom pipe, which you can create by dragging those elements from the left onto the right side. So what you want to drag there is your MIDI in. And in fact, I have a controller here. I'm going to turn it on. And since it's a Bluetooth controller, let me just quickly connect it that way. If you have a standard controller, you can just plug it in. And now if I click on the MIDI in on my pipe, I will see the blue board, that's the name of my controller, among the possible inputs. So now this is my input. And then the next thing you want to do is you want to drag the A-list module here. And this, all it does is it tells you what MIDI messages are being sent. And we're going to need to take note of those for later. So I have four buttons here. I'm gonna press the A button. As you can see, if I hold it down, there is a certain message that appears there, and if I let go of it, there is a second message that is being sent. So what is important to us are these numbers right here. So number 176 means that we are sending a continuous control message type on channel one, okay? So those two pieces of information are translated into the MIDI world as number 176. Now the next number is 20, meaning that the number of our continuous controller is 20. And in fact, if I press another button here, you can see that the message is identical, except that now it's number 21, and this one is number 22, and this one is number 23. And then the last number here, or numbers rather, are the value. So on press down, the value being sent is 127, and upon releasing the button, the value being sent is 0. So that's important, because what we're gonna do now is we're gonna create a very short and very simple and intuitive AppleScript, and then we're gonna use MIDIPipe to make sure that our MIDI information triggers that AppleScript, which is gonna tell GarageBand to perform certain things. So let's open up GarageBand. I'm just gonna create a new project from scratch, just like you would probably. It's gonna be a guitar kind of project. And then I'm just gonna go down here to plugins. And in my case, I have four buttons. I want these to turn on and off pedals, right? So I'm gonna open the pedalboard. Good, so by default it has two pedals here. That's good for starters. We can add pedals later on. So the next thing you want to do is you want to open your script editor. So open Spotlight and fire up the script editor. And what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to create a very simple script, and then we're going to test a couple of things and I'll walk you through it. So the first thing you want to type in is tell application, wait, maybe let's capitalize that, system events. Because even though we are triggering GarageBand, we are doing so by using the click function, okay? And clicking on something is a system event. So we wanna tell GarageBand to do something through a system event, right? And that system event is click button. Let's start with number one. We're gonna test our way right through this to find out what button exactly corresponds to the on-off switch on the pedals. So click button one off window, and the window here is called guitar one. So let's just put that in quotes. Guitar one off application process guitar band. And then we're gonna end the tell command. Seems pretty easy and straightforward, right? So if you want to check if there's any mistakes in the syntax here, you can click on the little hammer icon here. Good, everything is okay. If there had been a mistake here, like if I had maybe added an on, which is not AppleScript language, as you can see, it would have given me a syntax error kind of message. So we have our script, and now we can just trigger it by pressing play, and let's see what it does to GarageBand. So it's gonna click on button one. I don't know yet what button one is. I mean, I do know, but I wanna show you what happens. So let's click here. Ooh, and we get an error message. And that is because for some reason I typed in guitar band. GarageBand, of course, is the right application process. So here we go. As you can see, it's collapsed our pedalboard window, which is what this button right here does. So this is button one. Okay, good. Let's test the next one, button two. Okay, so that would be this little button here that collapses and expands this part of the window here. So that is two, and then three probably is this one right here, right? There we go. So this could be useful in its own right, right? Because say you wanted to deactivate all of your pedals at once, you could use button three to do that. Good, so these first three buttons are just common across all windows of GarageBand, I would say, right? Because they pertain to the header here, to the plugin container. So with number four, we are finally gonna enter into the specifics, into the nitty-gritty of the pedal board. So let's just try number four, and look at that. It moves this switch here from treble to full. Okay, so let's try number five. And that is it, that's the one we're looking for. As you can see, it activates and deactivates this pedal. The exact number of the button is gonna vary between setups, right? Because on this particular pedal, we only have two buttons, right? We have this treble full switch and then the on-off button. But if we had something like this tremolo pedal right here, right? Let me see if I can drag it here. There we go. So this one has a sync button, and then it has a bunch of buttons down here. So button number five in that case is this speed up button here. So if this is your first plugin, you're gonna need to do some more experimenting. I'm just gonna get rid of this. And by that same token, if you want to switch to the next pedal, this switch right here from fast to slow is probably gonna be button six, and the on off switch is gonna be button seven. So let's see if that is true. Let me type in seven, and as you can see, it turns on and off the pedal. Good, so now we have the Apple script that will activate and deactivate our single pedals in our pedal board. The next step is to make sure that we associate a MIDI message to this script. To do that, we go back into MIDIPipe, and we scroll down here, and there is an AppleScript Trigger module. How beautiful is that? Let's just drag it onto our pipe. So as you can see, it comes with a bunch of lines of text already, which are actually quite useful to us because we can keep them as a starting point and just edit the words we need to change. So the first line is on run me message, and that is basically what associates a certain MIDI message with another action. So we're gonna keep that, and of course the corresponding end run me message at the end. So on run me message, we wanna tell the application system events. And then we have this if line, which defines our message. And this is why it was so important to use the A-list module at the beginning, because now we know exactly what our MIDI messages look like, and now we can specify which message should do what, right? If item one of message is 176 in our case, and item two is 20, ISOM 3 is larger than 0, and this is important because remember that my buttons here are not toggle kind of buttons, they are temporary buttons. That means that I would trigger the on-off switch of my pedal just so long as I kept pressing the button. And as soon as I released the button, then the pedal would be turned off again, which is not what you want. You want to click on the pedal, let go, the pedal stays on. Click again and it turns off, right? So that is why we only use values larger than 0. Basically, releasing the button, which sends a value of 0, is going to be ignored. So let's keep this like that. Change this second message as well to 176, and in this case 21. That's my second button here, right? So if this is the kind of message, then what? We don't want it to say MIDIPipe, right? We wanted to click buttons 5 and 7, right, of GarageBand. So button 5 in the first case, and in the second case, button 7. Then we have an end tell line, which you need when you have a tell line, right? And that is pretty much all of it, right? Notice how it says not compiled up here. That is because we need to save this pipe we just created. Let's save it on the desktop and call it GarageBand pedals. Right, then you need to quit MIDIPipe, open it again, open your pipe you just created, and now if you click on the AppleScript Trigger module, it says compiled. So let's see if this worked. If we did everything correctly, then pressing my first two buttons here should turn the pedals on and off. So I'm going to press the first one. And as you can see, every time I press it, I activate the pedal or I deactivate it. And the second one works as well. So now that we know how this works, seeing as I have another two buttons here, let's just add some more effects. Let's say, for instance, this one right here, this auto-funk effect. So this one has three switches here. So these are probably buttons 8, 9, and 10. And then the on-off switch is probably 11. So you know, you could test this out with the script, but in fact, I'm gonna close this script editor. I'm just gonna guess that that button is gonna be button number 11. So I'm just gonna copy these two lines. All right, I'm gonna duplicate them. And in the item 2 of message, I'm gonna put 22, which is my third button. And then I wanted to trigger button number 11. Okay, so I'm guessing this is going to be 11, and then maybe let's use this rainbow delay here. Now this one also has a switch here and another three buttons down here. So if this is 11, this is probably 12, 13, 14, and 15, or maybe 14. I don't know, let's go with 14. So again, I'm going to duplicate the line here. This time it's going to be CC23, my fourth button on my MIDI controller. And then I'm going to put in 14 here. Save this. Again, we did some changes, so it's not compiled. We need to quit MIDIPipe and open it again. Open our pipe. And now let's see if we did everything correctly. So I'm going to press on my third button here. Okay, it turns the auto funk effect on and off. So that one we guessed correctly. And now I'm gonna press my fourth button. And as you can see, it activates the listen button here. So the listen button is button number 14. So I guess it was 15 after all. So no problem, we can do that change on the fly. Just change this to 15, save, quit, open again, load our pipe. And this time around, as you can see, it's the on-off message. Beautiful. And of course, I'm only using buttons in this tutorial because I only have buttons on my MIDI controller. But I don't know if you can see this, but my blueboard has a couple extra inputs here for expression pedals. So I'm actually planning on buying an expression pedal because I would really like to control this pedal right here, the whammy emulation. And as you can see, the pedal here is not an on-off kind of switch. It has different degrees that it can have, right? Press it down or all the way up or anywhere in between. And so that's perfect for an expression pedal. So once I get my pedal, I'm gonna experiment and see what the syntax is for this, because it's probably not gonna be button number something. It's gonna be, I don't know, slider or whatever. And what do you do? Do you click a slider like you click a button, or maybe it's press, or I don't know. I'm gonna find that out and I'm gonna make another tutorial for you guys. So, but for now, this is it. I hope this was useful to you. If it was, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And share this with a friend of yours that uses GarageBand as well and has been frustrated with it not being able to receive MIDI to trigger all of these things. And that being said, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video next week. Take care.